we're going to show to you the application of double blades, double ginonte, and its application of the knife and the blade. Now, this is highly dangerous. So what you see here, don't practice this anywhere, but keep under the supervision of somebody who knows how to work with you with a blade. Do not work for yourself without first having instructions, because this is dangerous. Now, when you move to this, since this is a live blade, be sure that this the instruction is properly followed carefully. And this requires a lot of discipline to handle the blade to blade. All right, so we're going to show to you the different movements with the use of the dye gloves and the use also of the most circular movements. So what is being worked on the double blade is done also with the principles of the knife and the blade. So you have the thrust and you have the slash. Then the working on the double blade is a very important part of the system. The working of the double blade and the way how it's being applied in terms of combat is the most important thing. So in our system, we have the principle of pushpushan, which is the use of the double blade and the use of the ginonte as a part of the movements. So if we're going to fix each other, we follow that movements in most graceful way. Within the every movement is very calculated in how it's being delivered. So when the blade follows after the other, then it has its own application there. See? All right, so it's important that during this process, there's not full amount of concentration so that if you are going to deliver that edges of the blade, it has to be accurately done in a manner that you expect it it will take only a couple of minutes and not seconds to cut the edge. The double blade is a very interesting technology in the Filipino blade culture. So in the movements, it has to be done in a manner that the blade is maintained properly. You have the proper motions and the proper angles of attack. And this is the way it is. Okay? In the knife culture, there are certain peculiarities of the blade. And one of these is the hagibis. The hagibis is a specially designed blade that is very effective for slashing. At the same time for thrusting. But initially, if you deliver the hagibis with such momentum of force, you will hear a different sound compared to other kinds of blade, which indicates that this blade is highly fast and very dangerous because of the balance. So you expect that during the time of the slash, there will be a complete decapitation of the arms and also any parts of the body. This blade is not common. It is a blade that is designed secretly for purposes of decapitating the enemy and completely destroying all fingers, all arms, and including legs. So the purpose of presenting this is to see to it that you must know how to distinguish the different blades under the Filipino knife culture. And we will hear this from Ryan here on how he delivers the blade with such a fantastic sound.
Okay, good. Excellent. Without sound, it's tremendous. So, in this presentation, you'll see that the Filipino culture, the knife culture, in terms of its philosophical values as far as the art is concerned, there is no mixture of anything. That's why we believe in the purity of the system, as our forefathers had been handed down the generation to generation of technology. That slash is uncuttable. And there's no way an empty hand could block this kind of knives. And forget about those empty hands and those cakes, because it will be solved by the simple slash. So if we're gonna go into some realities, go into the real thing. And this is what this is about. We are trying to present the danger that anybody would have to encounter with a person who is proficient in terms of knife culture. And this is the Filipino technology. So those who are learning, be careful. It is highly dangerous. Don't practice it until the time you are properly supervised by a competent expert in terms of knife technology. And this is how it is in the knife culture out of all Filipinos.